Building a pool is an extremely emotional experience and process. The customer has spent a lot of time and money planning their perfect backyard, and they're anxious for it to turn out well. The last thing you want as a plaster crew, a startup technician, or a builder is for a panicked homeowner to call about imperfections or dusting in their surface. The Orenda Startup was forged out of necessity by several forward-thinking people in the pool industry to avoid common problems during the pool startup process. Problems like plaster dust and super high pH. The Orenda Startup method was designed to get ahead of these issues and pre-treat the water with calcium and our chelating agent, SC-1000, before it goes into the freshly surfaced pool. I'm Jared with Orenda, and today I'm going to show you how to perform the Orenda Startup method. To get a better understanding of why we want to pre-treat the water with calcium and SC-1000, let's briefly cover what causes plaster dust in the first place. Tap water is almost always low on the LSI. That means it's low on calcium saturation and water wants to reach equilibrium. In other words, it's hungry for calcium and will take it from the most readily available source, the surface. The most soluble form of calcium is called calcium hydroxide, and a freshly plastered pool is loaded with it. That means the brand new pool is basically an all-you-can-eat buffet for aggressive water. A freshly plastered pool can lose a lot of calcium due to the unbalanced water on startup. Here's how it happens. Aggressive water fills the pool and it begins taking calcium hydroxide from the surface. This is what some people call the natural rise or the drift up of calcium. This goes on until the water reaches equilibrium. So, if you've ever seen plaster dust on the bottom of a pool, that was calcium hydroxide that the water took from the surface and got carbonated into dust. But if the water needed the calcium, why is it on the floor and not dissolved into the water? Calcium hydroxide is extremely high on the pH scale at 12.6. That high pH in turn spikes the pH of the water itself, which raises the LSI until it reaches equilibrium at 0.00. Once it reaches that point, it's not hungry anymore. If you've seen any of our other videos about the LSI, you'll remember that water cannot oversaturate itself. This pH spike leads to another common problem. When the startup technician arrives at the pool to begin the process and the pH is really high, they will usually think it's time to add acid, which in turn throws off the LSI and makes the water hungry all over again. The Orenda Startup prevents the loss of calcium hydroxide from ever starting, which prevents both dust and misleading pH spikes. By pre-treating some of the fill water with pre-dissolved chelated calcium, we can bring the pool into an LSI range of plus 0.2 to plus 0.5. Before we get into the procedure, let's go over the equipment. To successfully perform the Orenda Startup, you will need the following: a test kit, a thermometer, a measuring cup, a fluid funnel, a tarp, a sock or a rag, tape for connecting the hoses, safety glasses and gloves, SC-1000, muriatic acid, calcium chloride, or if your tap water exceeds 300 parts per million calcium, you can use sodium bicarbonate instead. And finally, the Orenda Startup Barrel complete with hoses. The purpose of the startup barrel is to pre-fill it, then treat the water with calcium and SC-1000, and sometimes muriatic acid if the pH of the tap water is 7.8 or higher. The platform allows us to connect up to two garden hoses to fill the pool. Water travels through the base and up the flex pipe. A hose is connected to this spigot that supplies fresh tap water to fill the pool. The ball valve here allows you to control the flow of water into the barrel, which will be important. On the side is a barb fitting that connects to the vacuum hose so that they stay together. This allows for the calcium-rich water in the barrel to complement the fill water at an even ratio. It is important to understand that the water in the barrel is trickling into the pool, not running at full blast. This is why the ball valve on the flex pipe is important. It controls the flow. In some cases where tap water has calcium over 300 parts per million, this barrel can also be used for a bicarb-based startup, which follows the same steps as the calcium startup, except you're adding sodium bicarbonate instead of calcium into the barrel. Be aware, Do not add calcium and sodium bicarb into the barrel together. These chemicals are not compatible and will create a precipitous reaction when combined with water. If the startup barrel isn't an option, buckets can be used instead. It's just a little bit more work. Step one is always to test the tap water. We need to know what the water temperature, pH, total alkalinity, and of course, calcium hardness is of our tap water. We take these water chemistries and input them into the Orenda app on the left side. We can see this water is just under where we want it to be with an LSI of 0.17. But it's not uncommon to have an LSI reading of minus 0.5 or less and a calcium hardness around 100 parts per million depending on your location. Once we've input our levels on the left side, we will adjust the right side of the calculator to meet our three parameters. Number one, a minimum calcium hardness of 300 parts per million. Number two, a minimum alkalinity of 100 parts per million. Number three, we want an LSI between plus 0.2 to plus 0.5. How you get your LSI between plus 0.2 and plus 0.5 should be between calcium hardness and alkalinity, but it's your choice. And remember, we can only adjust one of these parameters at a time. Before we get started setting up our tank, we will want to address the spa or negative edges. Getting water into our freshly plastered spa or negative edge prior to filling the pool is important. If a freshly plastered surface is exposed to the elements for an extended period of time, it can cause unsightly cracks. Be aware, if the pool or spa has an in-floor cleaning system, it's a good idea to plug the floor heads prior to filling the spa to prevent the backflow of water into the pool. Once the spa is roughly halfway to 3/4 of the way full, you will want to address the water. You want to get a bucket and start dissolving 1 to 2 pounds of calcium with 8 ounces of SC-1000 and roughly 4 ounces of acid if the pH of the tap water is 7.8 or higher. You want to give time for this to dissolve and cool down before you add it to the spa. Once it's cooled and thoroughly mixed, you pour your bucket into the spa and mix it around so that it has even distribution within the water. Then fill the rest of the spa and stop it before it reaches any negative edges or overflows. For negative edge pools, the procedure is the same as it would be for the spa. The only difference is the amount of water we're treating. Since negative edges are usually bigger than spas, we have to figure out how many gallons we're trying to treat. Ask the builder or input the measurements into our volume estimator within the app. Step two. While the plaster team is finishing up the pool, we will need to set up the barrel and get it filled halfway with water. The setup takes just a couple of minutes. First, lay a tarp down on the edge of the pool, just in case anything spills when we're using the barrel. On fill-up day, we bring calcium chloride, muriatic acid, and SC-1000. The following day, we will usually add sodium bicarb based on how much the Orenda app tells us we need to adjust the alkalinity. Next, we put our barrel down and attach all of the hoses and then turn them on. Once the barrel is set up, we open the valves to fill the barrel, but make sure the spigot remains closed at this time as the pool is not yet ready for water. Step three, add the necessary amount of calcium to the startup barrel, or if using buckets, divide it up among several buckets. The calculator is telling us we need roughly 44 pounds of 94% strength calcium chloride. In some cases, it may be necessary to add upwards of 100 pounds of calcium. Pay attention to the strength of the calcium you're using. The Orenda LSI calculator will give dosing instructions that are based on the strength of the calcium, and there are several different strengths on the market. Also, be aware, dissolving calcium chloride gives off a lot of heat. It can burn you, so please be careful. If the pH of the tap water is 7.8 or higher, we will add roughly 8 ounces of muriatic acid to the barrel to accelerate the dissolving of the calcium. We also add some SC-1000 directly into the barrel to help chelate the calcium before it ever goes into the pool. Then we stir the calcium in and let it cool down. It should clear up fairly well prior to turning the water on and filling the pool. For now, we wait until the plaster crew is finished. Step four. Once the plaster crew is done and they give us the green light to fill the pool, we will need to tie the vacuum hose and the fill hose going into the pool together. We want to make sure that we tie a sock or a rag on the end of these hoses. You will also want to tie an empty bottle on the end of these hoses so that it floats as water is being introduced. Place them in the bottom of the pool in the deepest part and turn on the water at the house. This will begin supplying water to the tank. Once the water's on at the house, open the spigot to fill the pool with the fresh water going down. Now, slowly open the ball valve to the barrel so the barrel begins to overflow nicely down the vacuum hose. The water flowing out of the barrel should be at a trickle. The stream should be about a half inch to an inch wide. Step 5. Use the fluid funnel to add 1 quart of SC-1000 per 10,000 gallons of water directly down the vacuum hose. This will get the SC-1000 into the bowl of the pool as it's filling. In some cases, it's acceptable to double the initial dose for better results. Step 6. When the pool is done filling, the float ball will rise and shut off the entire system. The next day, we'll return, check the water chemistry, and make any necessary adjustments, add CV600, clean up, remove the barrel, and brush the pool. If we did it right, all we'll be brushing is dirt and debris. Please be aware, we've run into instances where we come back the second day and it looks as though there's plaster dust all over the floor. In reality, this is just calcium that has fallen out of suspension and coated the floor due to a high pH. Simply lowering the pH to 7.5 to 7.8 will make the calcium go back into suspension. Now that you see how to implement the Orenda Startup procedure and the importance of pre-treating your tap water prior to fill up, we hope you can carry this proactive approach to pool care over into your regular maintenance. This philosophy helps to prevent problems down the line and has the added benefit of giving your customer peace of mind. The Orenda Startup has undergone several changes and will likely continue to change in order to deliver the best results possible. We want to take this time to thank those of you that have adopted the use of the Orenda Startup method and helped us dial in the best practices. We appreciate your feedback, and you are how we will continue to improve this process. We are so grateful for the opportunity to serve you. Once again, I'm Jared with Orenda, and if you have any further questions about the Orenda Startup process, please visit our website, reach out via social media, or give us a call.